following short film, I will be exploring the sustainability issue of factory farming. Modern intensive farming, a controversial method of animal production, will be critically analysed with a focus on history and background, as well as the benefits and implications. A comparison of operations between countries will be performed, and finally, an informed conclusion will be made, and hopefully you all walk away with an educated opinion regarding the sustainability of factory farming.
In the Industrial Revolution in the 18th century, the human population has grown and advanced at alarmingly rapid rates, and the need for food production and consumption has had to keep up with demand. Who are you eating? That is the question, published by the Sydney Morning Herald and written by Mark Beckhoff, is an article that addresses the connection between factory farming and environmental damage. Beckhoff urges humans to consider their food choices as we are leaving too big of a carbon footprint, which refers to the large amount of greenhouse gases released into the atmosphere by the livestock industry. The following short clip will enable an understanding of factory farms and how they operate.
But now we've got a factory farm, E-I-I-L-O. And on this farm, 50,000 chickens, E-I-I-L-O. They can't run around, they're six to a gauge, their beaks are chopped, they cannot stretch, they cannot flap, their bones do snap, it's all part of life on a factory farm, E-I-I-L-O.
As you can see, farming today is no longer grassy paddocks and barns, but instead, animals are being taken off the fields and restrained to immobilization in a mechanically operated steel cage or crate.
The rapid growth and advancement of factory farming has become a huge sustainability issue. Not only has it become unethical and inhumane to the animal and human populations, but it has damaged the ecosystem and become a negative impact on the environment through soil erosion, deforestation, loss of native habitat, and a contributor to greenhouse gases, adding to the warming of the planet.
This image displays above-ground woody biomass, which is the residue left from tree destruction. The figure shows that approximately 260 million acres of forest in the United States has been cleared just to create cropland, which feeds animals raised for food in factory farms. The scientific basis of factory farming revolves around convenience and obtaining the greatest output of animal product in a cheap, efficient manner, with the 2009 report indicating intensive farming systems contribute to 70% of the world egg and poultry meat.
Modern-day intensive farming is largely a topic of debate, because although it has multiple negative implications on the sustainability of the planet and contributes to a large amount of human and animal suffering, it has a number of benefits economically and societally.
In an article by Cox 2011, it is made evident that 50% of farmland in the state of Iowa in America is owned by people over the age of 65. This image displays the number of jobs created and the revenue generated from factory farming under Iowa State Research, and it is clear that factory farming operations are financially sustainable for human survival.
As suggested by Gold's 1983, factory farming is an economic necessity as it is the only possible way of feeding the given population without the price of meat excessively soaring. If all farmers were to adopt a sustainable method of farming, such as the traditional grassy paddocks for roaming and barns for resting, maintenance costs will rise for farmers and consumers will therefore be forced to adopt a higher price rise. Factory farming evidently plays an important and somewhat essential role, not only in maintaining a sustainable economy, but also in regulating thousands of jobs and determining a source of income for those who cannot work. As stated in a 2009 article, sustainability is determined on the principle that we meet the needs of the present without compromising the needs of future generations. With factory farming growing at such a fast rate to cater for the demographic, and therefore contributing largely to deforestation, there are large concerns relating to the future of the world's forests.
The sustainability issue of factory farming occurs all over the world, wherever there is a demand for food production. As previously mentioned, America has an extremely large population, so food production through factory farming has a particularly large role within their society. Although legislation differs among country to country, the overall ramifications of water pollution, soil erosion, deforestation, and an increase of greenhouse gases due to factory farming remains present.
Who are you eating? That is the question, published by Mark Beckhoff, originally suggested that factory farming was creating a damaging carbon footprint and is destructing the planet, urging that we analyze our dietary choices as a result. After critically analyzing both the benefits and implications of factory farming on people, place, and profit, it can be concluded that factory farming is sustainable to the economy but unsustainable to the environment, which creates benefits for people now, however fails in regards to a cradle-to-grave approach. It is credible to suggest that humanity needs to reevaluate the way in which we treat our animal population, as to reduce the exploitation on the environment, as meat production through factory farming is not at all sustainable for our planet through a long-term perspective.